The delegation of Singapore.
Delegation of Finland. Now you're recognized to speak for 50 seconds, establish. Delegation of Ireland. Now you are recognized to speak for 50 seconds, establish.
Thank you, sir, for your recognition. So, as we're talking about child mortality rate, so far in 2019, over 1 million pregnant and lactating women were educated on infant and young child feeding, IYCF, in the effort to improve survival, growth, and development of children. A total of 1.7 million pregnant and lactating women received IYCF counseling in 2019. Delegate of Ireland strongly believes that through such resolutions, somehow the life of children and the women could be saved in Yemen. And every country should come together, despite their own personal conflicts, to help Yemen. And Ireland has already contributed.
Thank you, Delegate. Your time is over.
Thank you, Chair.
Delegate of Nigeria.
House. Delegate of Nigeria would like to speak on child mortality rates. Actually, the child mortality rate has remained a major challenge to public health among families in Nigerians and also in other developing countries. There's also a high rate of mortality with suicide and bearing and also other factors. The child mortality rate is also a fundamental measurement of a country's level of social, economic, and demographic development. Reports from Nigeria have revealed that mortality experiences ranging from non-mortality mortality, infant and child mortality, so maternal mortality are also high. And Nigeria still has a very high.
Delegation of Ireland, you are now recognized to speak for 50 seconds, establish.
Thank you, Chair, for your recognition. The delegate of Ireland would like to say, so far in 2019, over 1 million pregnant and lactating women were educated on infant and young child feeding, IYCF, in the effort to improve survival, growth, and development of children. A total 1.7 million pregnant and lactating women received IYCF counseling in 2018. This delegation strongly believes that through such resolution, the life of children and women could be saved in Yemen, as Ireland has already contributed €22 million since 2012 to the UN Pool Fund for Yemen. Thank you.
Thank you, Delegate. Delegates, the floor is open. Is there any motion in it? Please write it down on chat box. Delegation of Canada, you're now recognized to wipe your point your eyes.
Thank you very much, Chair. The delegates of Canada would like to move the motion for education.
Delegates, the delegation of Canada just proposed a motion. Is there any delegation against it? Since not, now we will proceed to the speaker list. Please write it down your name on chat box if you want to be included. Delegation of Finland. Now you are recognized to speak for 50 seconds, establish.
Thank you, Chair, for your recognition. I'm really sorry for the network issues earlier. First of all, education should be available and equal to everyone. No discrimination should take place on the basis of gender and caste. Depending upon the literacy rate, education should be something like each one teach one. Homeschool concepts should be included. Now in homeschool, I'm just talking about the general schools, not the religious one. Look, I would like to say one thing that in Yemeni law, one clause could be different, not the whole. The country is not governed, the people are not governed on one single clause, it's the complete book. For human benefit, it's made. We humans are not supposed to like completely get dependent upon it.
Your time is over.
Thank you.
Delegation of Canada, now you're recognized to speak for 50 seconds, establish.
Thank you, Chair. As we all know, education is a bedrock to bright futures. It increases increase in education, reduces poverty and boosts economic growth. It increases individuals' ability to lead a healthy life. And as such, in 2012, UNICEF launched the Out of School Children Initiative with the UNESCO Institute for Statistics to ensure the reduction of out of school children worldwide. And over 90 countries have joined the initiative since its launch. And as effort to fulfill the SDG 2030 goal, UNICEF is expanding education system to capture the children most at risk as they partner with organizations. Thank you.
Thank you, Delegate. Delegation of Ireland. Now you're recognized to speak for 50 seconds, establish.
Thank you, Chair, for your recognition. Despite the challenges faced, UNICEF, along with its partners in the field, succeeded to facilitate education for 204,340 children in Yemen, around 49.7% of girls, through major rehabilitation of 18 affected schools and latrines in 218 schools. Also, 4,055 teachers and social workers, including social workers and all the other who helped Yemen in their difficult times, received training on physiological support, benefiting around 133,356 Yemeni children. Moreover, 1,907 students have received basic learning supplies, including schools, bags, and badges.
Thank you. Your time is over.
Thank you, Chair.
Delegation of Italy, now you're recognized to speak for 50 seconds, Dalish.
Thank you, Chair, for recognition. It is the present author's personal belief that the education is the main, if not the only, factor through which others can be easily revived. Such a